If you know a piece of music completely, then you tend not to want to listen to it anymore. There still has to be some challenge in it. You still have to track it, and sometimes music is so complex, it just sounds like noise. So it's too challenging, and then there's other music that's catchy the first two times you hear it, and then you never want to hear it again. There's too much predictability and not enough chaos. And hopefully you find a piece of music that's somewhere in the middle. You can listen to it 50 or 100 times, and each time you listen to it, there's still some new nuance in it that you didn't expect before. You kind of want to set up your life like that. The phenomena of meaning manifests itself at the locale of optimal challenge. And so that's a matter of calibrating the game properly, right? You want to play a game that you can play today, but also one that you can play next week and next month. We're not talking about your career this week. We're talking about you having a career that lasts 30 years, that doesn't kill you, that doesn't make you hate yourself or the job, that doesn't make you bitter, that doesn't wear you to a frazzle. So it has to be optimized. And so I think that you can, in fact, decide to take on the load that's optimally meaningful if you want, and then you get to have your cake and eat it too. You're on the pathway to continual incremental improvement. You only have to burn off a feather at a time instead of having the whole bloody thing burst into flames. But it's a constant source of renewal. But there's rules. You have to aim at the highest possible good that you can conceive. And that's subject to update, because what the hell do you know? But you start by aiming at the star you can see rather than the dimmer one that you can't yet perceive. You're going to decide that being is worthwhile and that you're going to work for its betterment. And that's a decision that's based on love. And the second decision is based on truth. You're going to play a straight game. Having made those two decisions, I think that you can allow your sense of meaning to calibrate your pathway. Responsibility is what gives your life meaning. And so then you might say, well, then take on ultimate responsibility. And what happens? You have an ultimately meaningful life. And then you might say, well, if your life is ultimately meaningful, it doesn't matter if it's punctuated by tragedy or even predicated on tragedy. It's worth it. And I think that's true. It's the choice of what game you're going to play. The answer, in some sense, to the tragedy of life, to the catastrophe of life, to the fall, is to adopt the responsibility of mortality that goes along with that, and to play that game maximally. And paradoxically, it's in the willingness to do that that the solution emerges. Life is suffering. Right. Indisputable. What do you do about that? You voluntarily accept it and then strive to overcome the suffering that's a consequence of that. And you do that for you, and you do that in a way that makes it better for other people. And then that works. And one question might be, well, how well does it work? And the answer is, the only way that you can find out is by trying it. That's it. That's the existential element of it. The proof is to be derived by the incarnation of the attitude in your own life. No one can tell you how it will work for you. It's the thing that your destiny is to discover that. and you have to make the decisions to begin with. It's like, you can't do this without commitment. You have to commit to it first. That's the act of faith. You have to say, I'm going to act as if being is good. I'm going to act as if truth is the pathway to enlightenment. I'm going to act as if I should pursue the deepest meaning possible in my life. And there's reasons to do none of those. They're real reasons. So it's really a decision. And the other thing that's so interesting about being alive is that you're all in. This is going to kill you. So I think you might as well play the most magnificent game you can while you're waiting. Why not pick the best thing possible that you could do? Why not do that? Maybe you could justify your wretched existence to yourself that way. I think you could. So maybe you could sort yourself out so that you wanted nothing but the good. And then maybe you could help make that manifest in the world. And maybe we wouldn't have all these terrible problems then. At least we'd have fewer of them, and that would be a start. So the answer to the problem of humanity is the integrity of the individual. That's the answer. Aim at the highest good. Tool yourself into something that can attain it. And go out there and manifest it in the world. All you have to do is give up your resentment and your hatred. You're blind to your own weaknesses, but you're also blind to your own strengths. And so then I think, well, if you got your act together, it'd be better for you, and instantly it would be better for your family, and then it would be better for the community. It's like, how far could you take that? If you stopped wasting time, and if you stopped lying, and if you oriented yourself to the highest possible good that you could conceive of, and you committed to that, how much good could you do? Well, I would say, why don't you find out? So that's what I think you should do. You should find out.